Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Steve Harrod. Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Harrod.
So thanks for coming back this morning. It's going to be a really fun something new here for the first time, which is the VMworld contest. And what we've invited to do is have all the Diamond sponsors come out, and they have exactly 4 minutes to present something interesting they're doing in terms of an integration with either the infrastructure side of the world that we've delivered or the end user side. And what's exciting is that each of them have picked a charity that they care deeply about. And you all should get your phones ready in just a moment. We're going to do some surveying here. You get to vote at the end on your favorite demo from one of these partners, and VMware is going to make a sizable donation to the charity of their choice. So those of you that haven't, get your phones ready. And at this point, I'm very happy to start off with our good partner, Cisco. Please join me in welcoming Jimmy Ray Purser and Rob Boyd. All right, guys, you guys are interactive on this whole thing. Hey, guys, welcome.
Hello.
Tell me about TechWise TV. What is this?
We are a customer-facing show that just makes networking technology accessible to our customers.
Okay, you're going to talk to us about VM mobility. What's that all about?
VM mobility. You know, a pretty interesting thing here, Steve. This is probably the only time you're ever going to see two Cisco guys on stage. Not trying to sell you something. We're going to talk about something open source, it's groovy, and it's a way to design data centers for mobility.
All right, you have precisely 4 minutes, so take it.
All right.
All right, man, let's get it done.
All right, I got to listen. I love this idea of Lisp so much that I wrote a song.
You wrote a song. We got to show it. You wrote a song.
Well, I'm going to share this little ditty about VM mobility. Gonna tell a tale about the gist of Lisp.
The gist of Lisp, all right.
Watch this.
Well, as your data center grows from New York to Tokyo, and your VMs start to flow, they'll want to move. Well, ISP, your network anatomy, can help you emerge, converge, and connect.
Geographic identity and how it connects to the network. Our hardware is what's doing the work to detect that. We're going to call those tunnel routers. And then our software is what maps all this stuff together and really makes everything work. That's the glue
all three things.
Of the best thing. All right, so let's get in here and take a peek at it, because one of the things that we know when we're designing out a data center is it's got to be transparent for our users and for our customers. So since VMs are no longer coupled to hardware anymore, man, I don't miss those days, huh? No. Decoupling is how it goes. So as we're moving VMs in and out of this cloud, we want to make sure that they're easy to find, that it's transparent for our customers to connect to. Now, the great thing about Lisp, besides being free, is that this will work on layer 2 if you're doing LAN extensions. It'll work on layer 3, so if you're doing cloud bursting. And you know, it really comes into play like if you're having an environmental condition like what's going on in Florida, and you got to bring up a disaster site really quick, but we don't want to go update DNS entries, no, have stale entries and all that stuff, and you have timeouts. Nobody wants that.
No liability there.
So as you're moving through, your tunnel router picks that up, and it keeps updating this mapping server so your user is always knowing how to connect back and forth to these devices. It never gets stale, it always gets new, and it's great, man. I mean, that is truly, in my opinion, the gist of Lisp. So if you look at designing out your network today, you look at designing out your data centers, this is probably the one piece that will make every solution you see on the floor, make everything you see from folks up here talking, really work. It's that underlying stuff. You know, the software looks cool, but I've got to have something to make that move. I can't move traffic until I've got a bridge, right? And man, to me, that's true love, man.
I wrote a love song and you scratch it in a tree.
Hey, we got a love song, let's sing it. We got 4 seconds.
That is Lisp.
Precisely on time. You have 4 minutes to the nose, so thank you. Please tell me, which charitable organization are you playing for?
We're playing for Kaboom, which is a nonprofit organization that builds playgrounds for kids who don't have the ability, like in large cities, to get their creative juices out.
Excellent. Thanks, guys. So everyone, take out your phones. After each session, we're going to do a quick polling question for you, something about the technology you just heard about. So in this case, which of the following options includes the three important things to understand and remember? So this is something that the guys here just taught you. Cue the music. All right, we're going to do software. Looks like the results are coming in. Guys, what do you think?
That's pretty cool.
Interesting. Okay.
Roughly as expected.
I think I'm more surprised how Steve is dressed. He's wearing parachute pants yesterday. You remember that?
On that note, thanks, guys, very much. We're going to move on.
Thank you.
Great
Thank
job.
You, everybody.
I see your dirty face high behind your collar.